Lahore Grammar School Quetta, lesson by Faizasha for grade 7, competent is language arts, and the topic of the day is the pan. Now, the pan might sound a very short topic or a very short, a very short topic, but it is going to be a lot of fun because pan is actually a way of saying something that is very intellectual, but then very funny at the same time. For example, you crack me up. Now, as you can see, the coconut is cracked here. However, crack me up means to make me laugh as well. So you crack me up, it means that you make me laugh. But then the picture is funny because the coconut is cracked. What's up, sugar? We normally call little children sugar, darling, sweetheart. We call them this because obviously they're cute. So here, however, the person who come up with the idea is the tea is calling sugar as what's up sugar, and the sugar is very cute and it's in pink. Then let the pan shine, fun punch to brighten your day. That is what we're going to do today, and you're so bright, that's what the moon is saying. And then the sun is wearing all those witty specs with the bow and with the book in his hand, in its hand actually, and it's looking very witty, it's looking very intelligent, but at the same time, bright means that apparently sun is bright enough that we cannot even look at it. So there are two meanings of bright here. Moving on, understanding pun. A pun is a play on words in which humor is created by the use of words that have the same sound but different meanings. The alert reader or hearer, it means that person who is listening, so it's a listener, not heater, is aware of both meanings and is able to appreciate the wit or cleverness involved. Puns are mostly the example of wits in a humorous way. You understand now? So a pun is a play on word. The word may sound the same, but there are two different meanings to that word. And then only an alert reader or an alert listener could tell them apart and can appreciate the wit or the cleverness that is involved in the sentence. For example, how do you organize a space party? You plan it. So if I say it quickly, you plan it, it sounds more like you plan it, right? So that is the catch here. So it's funny. Now, there are other funny examples. For example, what do the buffalo say to his son when he left for college? Bye, son. When someone is leaving, how do we send them off? We tell them bye-bye. We say bye. And that is what the buffalo is saying, bye, son. But at the same time, only a witty person, only an intelligent person would know that the baby of a buffalo is also called a bison. The hypocrite. Now, a hypocrite is a person who's double standard, right? They would have all the flaws in themselves, but they would, make you realize that you're the person who's wrong or you're the one with the flaws. Same way, a hypocrite, you should really watch your weight. Now, look at the hippo. It's all overweight, but is giving advice on weight. So it's a hypocrite. Cool? So how do you put a baby alien to sleep? You rock it. Once again, if you listen to it very carefully, you rock it. But if you read it, it's you rock it. Now, what is the difference? It is that you rock it, right? When you want to put a baby to sleep, what do? You rock it in a cradle or in your arms, or that is how we rock a baby to sleep. So that is what it is said here, but in a different way. So there is an alien in a rocket, and then you rock it. You let the rocket fly. So it's funny. Right, next. I'll fight you with my bare hands. And the bear is saying, oh dear. Now, bare hands, the deer is wearing those bare hands, but it doesn't mean that the speaker is trying to say bare hands. The speaker is trying to say bare hands, as in my hands without weapons. I will just hit you with my hand directly and I'm not going to do anything else. I don't have a weapon or I don't have anything in my hand, but I'll just do it bare hands, right? So However, but in the picture, it's funny because it has bear claws. The deer is wearing bear claws, right? And the bear is saying, oh dear. Oh dear, as in the deer is standing in front of him. But here he's, what the bear is trying to say is, oh dear, as in D-E-A-R, deer. What do you call a lazy kangaroo? Pouch potato. Now, we all know that a lazy scrounger, a person who is very lazy, is called a couch potato. But what do you call a kangaroo? Since a kangaroo have a pouch, it's called a pouch potato. You understand? So that is how it's funny. What do you call an alligator in a vest? An investigator. Right? So this is how it is witty, but then at the same time, it's funny. Right? Now, exercise, choosing the right word. This exercise, there are 10 of them. Yes, 10, but that's 20 because the words are exactly the same. They sound exactly the same. As you can see, the gamble and gamble, you can say moral and moral, soul, soul, or sight, sight. So they are almost the same, right? Like incredible and incredulous, they're not the same, but you know, close enough. So you need to put them in the blanks and send them over to me so that I can check it for you and would know if you understand what a pun is. So these are homophones. They're quite very close to, they almost sound the same, but they have different meaning. Look for the meaning so that it'll be easy for you to put them in the blanks. Best of luck, and I'll be looking forward to receiving your homeworks. Stay home, stay safe.